All right, hello and welcome to another episode of the Bradford City Career Mode. Today is my birthday and I'm a little bit worse for wear, so if I sound, you know, inebriated through the whole episode, it is because I am inebriated through the whole episode. So, yeah, be warned, I guess. I guess that would be the best thing to say. But anyway, if you didn't see the last episode of the Bradford City Career Mode, we took on Arsenal in the quarterfinal, I think it was, of the Carabao Cup. And we beat them 3-1. I think that was a home game as well. We were at the ye old Valley Parade for that. And this time, only 3 days later, we take on Bournemouth, the Cherries, back in the Premier League in a kind of, I don't know, a Premier League game. I'm trying to get Twitch set up. This is probably not the best thing to do while I've had alcohol, because I've absolutely no idea if it's working or not, but I guess, I'm assuming it will be. But like I said though, we're going to be playing against Bournemouth. Let me rotate the squad a little bit. This will probably be the only episode ever that you get completely drunken, or not completely drunken, I'd say. Very tipsy, we'll say. Obviously me streaming, that's the only time you get very tipsy, me streaming, because otherwise I wouldn't do this, because I thought I was gonna record an episode earlier in the day and I didn't. That's kind of where we're at right now. It's a ye old drunk career mode episode. Where's Hakimi? Has he disappeared? Or no, I'm just blind. Okay, got it. I'm just blind, don't worry. Guys, I've got no eyesight. It's cool. Alright. I think that's the squad we can roll with. I'm putting Martensen in ahead of Tielemans because I am not sure if Tielemans could do a full game. And since we're against Bournemouth anyway, I think we should be fine. But we'll save the team sheet, I should say. Yeah, this is going to be a mess of an episode. More than usual, due to the alcoholized state that I'm in. But we'll take a look at the news before we head in. We've got Hloszczyk completes hat-trick against Arsenal. Hloszczyk scored the last goal of the match and completed his hat-trick to help his team seal away a 3-1 win against Arsenal. Before I go in though, actually, I will show you who we've got next in the Carabao Cup semi-final. Just to keep you guys updated on the whole thing. I think I showed it at the end of the last episode. But I will show you guys once again. We've got Manchester City at the Etihad. I think it's a two-legged sort of thing. That's what it said in the calendar anyway. But we'll be playing Manchester City. We'll start off at the Etihad and then we'll play the second leg at the Valley Parade. Then we've got Chelsea and Spurs in the other semi-final. So we'll either face Chelsea or Spurs if we get through. But I think that is everything covered. There was a 2025 Player of the Year thing I kind of want to see. Do kind of our players a bit for nomination? Nope. Cool. Three Bayern players. I think there's a bit of favouritism here. New shortlisted candidates for Player of the Year have been revealed today. Coaches, captains, selected media, and the fans love a say in the week to come about who is the most deserving player to claim the reward. Pundits have suggested that Felix, Gnabry, Jovic, and Guedes all stand a chance of scooping the prize in the ceremony held this coming December. Imagine if we have one of our players yeet in and take that reward. That'd be mad. But anyway, speaking of rewards, we have got a player of the month. It is Kai Havertz winning the November player of the month reward. Havertz's impressive performance for Bradford City earned him the Premier League player of the month award for November. The nominees, if you have forgotten, I will remind you, we had Vinicius Jr. from Bradford City, of course, Havertz from Bradford City, Kane from Spurs, and Lozano from Chelsea, and Havertz has ended up winning that. And bad news, actually, I'll cover it now. Bad news for anyone who is a Bradford City fan. West Yorkshire rivals Leeds United, have been promoted to the Premier League. They're back in the Premier League, I think 16-year absence it was, but Leeds have made it back to the Premier League, so full credit to them. But any Bradford City fans, or any fans who are not a fan of Leeds, like me, I don't really enjoy Leeds, to be honest. I'm not really a fan of them. Kind of annoyed, but fair play to them for making it back to the Premier League. But anyway, we've got Donnarumma in goal, Akimi and Wan-Bissaka as the fullbacks, Militao and Kanate as the centre-backs, Martinsson as the centre defensive midfielder, Vinicius as the left midfielder, Dembele as the right midfielder, Havertz absolutely exhausted in that center attacking mid role, but I think he'll be alright. We can bring Kurtu on if need be as well. And then we've got Haaland and Greenwood up top. So I'm hoping, despite the fact that I'm intoxicated, we can get the victory here. But then again, I'm not expecting anything in this match, to be honest. It's my birthday, so I don't really care too much. But of course, we've got to stick to daily uploads. So birthday or not, we've got to stay on this career mode grind. But I am, if anyone wants to know or care, I guess, I'm 22 today. So I'm a year older. I've been to the pub and came back and got a takeaway. I was going to go out again, but I've decided against that. I just bought some stuff for home because I don't want to risk, you know, the old COVID-19. But before we get to this match, I'm just going to quickly get another drink. So I'll be back in a second. I'll be muting my mic for this quickly. I won't be long. I'm Derek Ray, ready to bring you commentary. And joining me is the former Arsenal defender, Lee Dixon. And we've got Premier League action coming right up. It's Bradford City, and they face Bournemouth.
Yeah, really looking forward to this one, Derek. Excite me. Come on, let's see some entertainment.
So the initial 11 for the home side. What do you think about this particular setup?
Well, strikers like support, and they've got support today in the number 10.
Right, I've returned. You can see our starting 11 here. The usual, besides maybe a couple. Just because of stamina reasons, we rotated the squad a little bit, maybe. Oh, no, it is the usual 11, actually, besides Martensen. Sorry if you hear me, like, crashing about and anything. I'm just opening my ye old bottle.
Here's how it looks for Bournemouth.
And the positioning it is my birthday after all. We've got Thiago Silva, goals, Daisy, Soyuncu, Uriah, and someone else, I didn't see who. Barbona, De Hood, Locatelli, and I can't read the right guy in time. But anyway, they've got Martin and Iheanacho. They've got Hanko left back, Limnios left mid. I'm hoping we could do it off. But Iheanacho is a solid striker. He'll be in his prime at this point. I'm not sure what his rating will be, but it'll be at his prime. Nice little bit of drink before we start. Without any further ado, let's get into this one. And now they get the ball rolling. Bradford City versus Bournemouth. I'm glad this isn't a top six team because I would be suffering. And this one, I feel like I can actually maybe be able to do something. Dembele. Haaland, not going to get there. Defenders come across, but Hakimi. Left to Martensen. Havertz. Greenwood. Oh, shit. Well, no, I'm calling this episode already. I don't even need to think of a title. It's because it's my birthday. I'm just going to call it Happy Birthday to Me, probably, or something. Something to do with my birthday. Oh, nice ball over my defense is so out of position, it's unreal. Oh, yes. Nice move. Pretty much scrambled it away. This isn't going to be an easy one. Donnarumma with a save. This is probably going to be a loss. I'm not going to lie to you guys. It's a very beatable team in Bournemouth, but the fact that it's my birthday and I've had a lot to drink will probably not help the proceedings here. And if you're watching at this point still, I apologise if this is uploaded late. I've been out for a lot of the day. So, I apologise for that. I was going to go out again, like I said, but I decided against it. We've had 14 games and scored 37 goals. It's the most in the league. We had that tally today. I don't know. Haaland looked like an option, but it was intercepted. Dembele can't get the ball, apparently, for some reason. They're playing quite well with some of these passes. Okay, Bournemouth. All right, these were relegation candidates last year. What the fuck is going on? Cutting infield here. They must finish. That will give them quite right. What? An early opening goal. Okay, well, let me. I know I've had alcohol. What a finish! But I need to process that. How's that gone in? How's that gone in?
so close, but it's in.
Fair play, he's taking the shot, but what? Let's go back to the goal that was scored. Barbona. Oh, come on.
Well, all the hard work has paid off, but the manager knows a lot.
My keeper's got to be better there, 100%. Barbona, it's his first goal in the Premier League. He's opened his account for the Cherries. But, like, how, so like, how's that not been stopped by Donnarumma? All right. When do you get serious now? This is ridiculous. If you lose to Bournemouth, I'm going to be slightly pissed. I don't mean alcoholically. I'm going to be slightly annoyed. Vinicius into Havertz. One more to Haaland? No, can't quite make it. I mean, I say can't quite make it. He's not even close to making it. Maybe I should have left it tonight and done a double upload tomorrow, but yeah. So you guys, is the only chance to get a proper tipsy career mode. That's what I'm playing against. Oh my god, this is a struggle. And a friendly reminder that we have more action from the Bournemouth will play Leicester up, next time at the Vitality Stadium. I can't remember what our next game is offhand. I think it's Ajax in the Europa League, but I cannot be 100% on that. Donnarumma. Havertz, can you get that? No? Okay, cool. What are these guys doing? Have I switched up a difficulty and not really noticed or something?
And the emphasis is on creativity. Iheanacho.
Look at a real note. As the difficulty changed, I've not realised. Bournemouth always went 2-0 up there. We're playing passes like a fucking top 6 team. I need a bit more drink. I'm going to have to drink to get me through this. Corner to Bournemouth anyway. Barbona with the corner.
And over comes the corner. Gets his glove on it.
Possibly by Donnarumma. Ain't fully away though, that's the thing, that's the problem. That's the issue we're dealing with. Militao, the key mate, it's played off the Bournemouth player, which means you get a throw, but I'm a bit concerned about how this has gone, and I knew it wouldn't be an ideal situation. But it's my birthday and I have no regrets.
Dembele.
That's a Greenwood maybe? Back into Dembele perhaps?
It's a weighted pass. No problems grabbing hold of that.
Shot? Nah, Thiago Silva got there. That's a rip. Thought maybe we could get the shot off, but nah. Kanate would have won the header if I was sober. Iheanacho. Right, Militao tackles Iheanacho. Martinsson. Out to Dembele. Back post, Haaland. Ah, it's been met by a Bournemouth defender. Corner for us, though.
Big corner here.
Right, lads, we need to get an equaliser and a winner, because to be honest, we shouldn't be dropping any points against Bournemouth, but we are doing currently, so I'm a bit concerned. Greenwood? Can't meet it. Out is going to receive the ball again. Off to Hakimi. Kanate, I don't really want to go to any of these central defender players, but Dembele. Oh, it's saved. Dembele can meet it again. No, Thiago Sabro. If he's going to be a problem, I'm going to get annoyed. The thing is, I can beat like top 16 for no problem, but when it comes to relegation threat inside, oh boy, we've got issues. Kanate should win that header, and does. Good fall to Haaland. Decent, actually. Dembele. Back to Haaland. Greenwood. Can't keep the ball. Oh, fucking hell.
A bit sloppy in possession.
Militao. Haaland. How have you not kept the ball there, bro? Like, was it? I don't know what's going on.
Now,
I don't know why we can't keep the ball.
Could be a chance to break here. Well, so many possibilities.
Back on Militao. We'll try again. Oh, for fuck's sake, just go through the defence, come.
Alan McAnally. It's a goal for Everton. 34 minutes, please. 1-0. Thanks very much, Haaland. As always, Alan.
It doesn't let me pass it off. I'm like fully passing it off there. It just tackles me before I can. I don't. Oh, bro, this is. I'm gonna get pissed off. I'm already pissed off, to be honest. I'll get more pissed off now, Donnarumma, to get that. Vinicius, come on, bro, get some speed going. There's no way Stacey catches up to me, right? Right, I'm aiming the A pass at Haaland. Why is it going off a defender before it gets to my player? Huh? Oh, fuck it now. Yeah, this is a big issue. Great stop by Donnarumma. It's how I can clear it, right? Yep, cool. Alright. I need to actually start, like, not being a bitch. Why did I pass that? That's why. That's not what I did. No, I want to have another chance of that. That's not what I did. Why have my defenders suddenly started, like, three real big of the other cord? Like, I'm not doing this. I'm not controlling them. I've custom tactics on the cunts and they're just like wandering off. That goes in, I'm actually slightly annoyed because my defenders are walking around like fucking zombies and going out of position like fucking zombies. I'm actually going to be so mad if I drop points here, I'm not going to lie. I don't care if it's my birthday and I've had a lot to drink. I'm just going to be annoyed. I'm going to be strap annoyed. The fact that we're 1-0 down to begin with pisses me off, quite frankly. Alvarez is going to have to win that, and he doesn't. What the fucking shit? How does he not win that? 3 minutes of added time in the first half. We might be able to get an equaliser if we're lucky. But then again, we could just let the ball run past us when I've not actually commanded it to do that. That's always an option too. Went in strongly, decisively. Let's have this. Let's have this, ref. Yes, 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 yes. Getting forward. Oh, thank God. I love referees in FIFA 20 career mode. Oh, Mason Greenwood, you absolute legend of a man. Oh, we've equalised against Bournemouth. That's not a sentence I imagined myself saying. Sober, it wouldn't even be in this fucking situation. But I'm not sober, so... But Greenwood buries it for his 11th goal in the Premier League season, and I am absolutely happy with that. I just, first time shot it, I hope, to be completely honest, and it worked out, and I'm happy it worked out. I'm happy it fell to Greenwood, instead of someone who hasn't got good shooting stats. But yeah, 11 goals in the Premier League for now for Mason Greenwood.
So, a level contest, 1-1.
And just before half-time, we've changed the complexion of the game. And with that, we've tied it up. Hear me burping at all or anything, I apologise, it's kind of uncontrollable. Havertz is the one getting like, why are you saying Havertz had a slowdown at first? Why do you say like Greenwood scored? And I know, just for clarification, that I messed up the word office there. I don't know how I messed that up. But anyway, 1-0 at half time, or I should say 1-1. Everton are beating Brighton 1-0. Liverpool are beating Crystal Palace 1-0. Fulham are beating Burnley 1-0. Manchester United are drawing 1-1 with Arsenal. Spurs and Chelsea are going to play later. Stoke are losing 1-0 as well to West Ham at half time. But this is a lot closer than I wanted / expected / thought it would be. But anyway, goal apiece, although we don't deserve it in this match. We're kind of like slacking, I'm not going to lie. 6 shots with 4 on target for Bournemouth. 2 shots with 2 on target for ourselves. 56% possession for the Cherries with 44% possession for the Phantoms. Stamina is going to be an issue for the foreseeable future. We're going to try and fix that now. I don't have Kutcher on the bench. Why don't I have Kutcher on the bench? I'm going to have to put Vlasic there. And Yuri there. And when it comes to striker, we'll see what happens. See what unfolds in the second half. I should have taken a drink. I don't care. I think I go. Right, lads. This is a team that was on the fucking verge of relegation. Back from the byline. How are we struggling so much? Huh?
And he takes it on. And a powerful effort.
If that goes in, that's mad, I'm not going to lie.
Wide, Derek. Decent effort. He smashed it.
Limnios went for a smasher, and if that had gone in, that might have been contender for goal of the season. This might be the first and last time I do a career mode episode under the influence. It's only my second episode on Twitch as well, after switching over yesterday, because I realised I wasn't allowed to show a mixer anymore through the Xbox. Oh, fuck off with your stats, we're going to win, I don't care. Loshek. Over, well, it was to Haaland, but I guess it wasn't to Haaland at the same time, you know? Throwing for Vinicius to take. I need some open options, and the only open option is Yuri, so we'll go him. Okay. If I'm like trying to pass it somewhere, this offside by Mile. No, but legit, if I'm trying to pass it off somewhere, can the game, in all its wisdom and infinite like everything, I've got pass assist on. Why is it going in a completely different direction to the like area I'm aiming for? Militao off to Hakimi. I'm gonna listen to this back tomorrow. I'm gonna be like, what the fuck was I thinking? The Yuri. Far from a good pass. Please just pass it to fucking Loshek. Holy Christ! Why is it going for a marked player?
An abundance of space.
What is the idea with the pass assist? Like, I'm aiming for an unmarked player, and the game's like, oh, you want to go to that player that's got three Bournemouth defenders on him? Yeah, sure, there you go, mate. Greenwood regains possession after Haaland. Back to Greenwood somehow. I don't know how it's worked, but I'm going to go for a shot. Just fuck it, no? Oh, shit. All right, Vinicius, follow up, mate. Okay, that's cool. And if I hit that with Dembele, it's offside, so I can't really follow up on that.
He's very adept at protecting the ball.
Yuri intercepts off to Hakimi, which is not where I aim, but that's alright. Vinicius.
Well, the momentum is there, the chances
are I don't have any options here, and there's electric. So many defenders back. Well, what can I do? Am I a magician? Do you want me to be a wizard?
Well, they have elected to go to the bench at
I'm
this
pretty sure there's
the
three Bradford City players there, and about seven or eight Bournemouth players. Locatelli, I believe, coming on for Kakaret. Or Locatelli, I should say, coming off for Kakaret.
And options in the centre.
Okay, you're not fine.
Tielemans.
Yo, we have to do it, guys. I'm sorry, we have to do it. It wasn't bad, to be fair. Forced to save out the keeper.
Yeah, that's what they do. Look at that save. A brilliant effort.
He went through the player's legs as well, the Bournemouth player. Forced to save out Thiago Sá, anyway. We might have to play a midfielder and striker, which might actually work, to be honest. My midfields have good finishing. But then again, Militao! Oh, fuck
well,
off, bro.
It's a decent effort, but it's a real opportunity goes begging there.
Yuri wins the header. After, well, it was off Dembele initially, but apparently the ball hasn't got its target. Militao. Oh, okay, I'm shit passing off there, but the game doesn't want to. Oh, there we go. And now I can't because of the marking. Yeah, okay. Yeah, all right. I understand what you try to say, FIFA 20. Basically, you're not letting me do anything. That's edible.
Greenwood.
Greenwood doesn't have enough fucking stamina, bro. I'm gonna have to sub off. I don't wanna. And I don't usually like substitute during open play, but I have to. All right, let's try this. I'm sorry for pausing an open play, because I usually wait till the ball goes out of play so the play doesn't get interfered with, but like, I just,
it might be on for them.
Just annoys me.
He's going forward well here.
I have a play, like, ready and waiting, and it just, I can't do it, because the stamina is at an all-time low.
It's a second goal for Arsenal. 69 minutes, please. 2-2.
Oh yeah, you can read that like a book, can you? Come. I swear a bit during episodes anyway, but this is more swearing than usual, so I apologise for that.
Still on level terms, moving the ball nicely.
Mambasaka with tackle. Greenwood. Can we send Haaland through? Probably not, because there's a defender waiting and he knows exactly where I'm going to go because it's gone the wrong fucking direction of where I wanted to play the LBY.
Well, he was in the right place to intercept.
I wanted it to go like past the defender in a position where Haaland could get it, but no.
And
they're reading me. They actually have me read like a book. We need to pull something out of the bag here. We need to pull a rabbit out of the hat. Regardless of the result, we're still top of the table, but I don't want to fucking drop points if I can help it against teams that I should be beating with no issue.
Vinicius Junior.
Go by Hakimi to Vinicius. Not who I was aiming for, but I mean, it could work. No, it couldn't because I've been fucking ramped. Nelly Tau. Hakimi to Yuri. Haaland. Now, legit, like, if my player has 90 strength, how on earth is he not winning that battle? I switch to my CDM, though.
This looks promising. And the cross is very much on.
This is a lot more close than I expect it to be.
Well, the header was respectable, but
if that had gone in, Donnarumma missed a save, you would have heard me blow a gasket. There's no excuse for not saving that if it wasn't target, to be honest, in my opinion, personally. All right, Donnarumma, please, can we pull a rabbit out of the hat? Holy Christ. That's fallen to Yuri. Vinicius. Sancho. What the fucking shit touch cunt is that, cunt? It's perfect, that's what it is. It's perfect, that's what it is. How has that worked out then? I apologise to my entire starting 11, plus the Salvage bench, plus the reserves, for that fit of anger there. I didn't realise that that was the plan, I guess.
Well, it's the hardest thing to do in football, score a goal.
On my birthday, Vlasic might have got us 3 points. I'll drink to that.
In terms of the goal that was scored.
Definitely haven't had a lot to drink already. Definitely won't wake up hungover tomorrow and regret the fact that not only have I got a career mode episode to record, but also the Extreme Rules horror show predictions. I mean, that's exactly how it's going to go tomorrow morning, but like, I will commit to what I have decided to record for this channel. There's occasions, very rare occasions, where if I'm really not feeling well, I will not do the career mode episode for that day. But I will double upload the next day to make up for the numbers. And I will 100% get the Extreme Rules horror show predictions out on time. I don't know how I'm going to do half the matches, because some of them are cinematic matches, which I don't think I'm physically able to do in 2K20.
Wan-Bissaka. Tielemans.
But I'll try to do my best with what I've got on the game. Vinicius, off to Hakimi.
Now with Hakimi.
99 pace. Hakimi. So if Barbona has 100... No, like, Barbona doesn't have 100 pace, though, does he? So it's a lie. Dembele. Gets a touch, gets a shot. It's saved. Haaland for the rebound. Oh, damn, it's wide. I think it's a corner, though. I don't think it was our player that hit that. We have got 45 seconds plus injury time to hold on to our slender lead that I actually don't know how we physically got on, but we have it. The belly. Vlasic? Nah, fam. Vinicius? How has he stumbled and yet still managed to win that? Hakimi.
Trying to make it a bit more
in the last minute.
The
I'm slightly annoyed, but my own fault.
They get forward, but time is very much against them here.
Nah, please.
And a very good
yes, Konate. No, Konate. Yes, Konate. It's going to be a goal kick and we can just boot it away. And by goal kick, I mean a what? How was it a corner?
Comes.
With a punch. Get out of there, get out of there, lads, get out of there. Don't let anything happen here that we can see an equaliser. play it back far enough that the game ends. Come on, lads, come on. Got to remember, no catch that, my dude. Just kick it off the pitch, bro. Kick it off, kick it off.
That's it. The referee brings the action to an end.
And we somehow pull a rabbit out of the hat. Under normal circumstances, I would expect a demolition of Bournemouth there, but due to the fact that they decided, yo, I'm going to turn up, and I've decided, yo, I'm going to get drunk on my birthday, we still won, but it's a slender win. I don't even remember who scored. That's kind of bad, isn't it? I know Greenwood got one. I think Kloschek got the other, right? Yep. Barbota scored for Bournemouth to open the proceedings. Greenwood cancelled out with an equaliser, and Kloschek ended up getting the winning goal with a bit of luck. But we do win somehow. We don't deserve it. Or maybe we do based on actual shot accuracy. We had 8 shots to 7 on target with 45% possession. They had 11 shots with 5 on target with 55% possession. Player of the match looks like it's going to be Dembele with an 8.5. I don't think he actually got a goal, but he got an assist, I guess. I guess that's what qualifies you for a Man of the Match award again. I don't know. But anyway, Greenwood gets an 8.1. Militao got an 8.3. I didn't even clock. Sorry, Militao. But yeah, you done well at the back. 8 for Loshek as well, which is decent. Man of the Match for Bournemouth. Barbona with an 8.5. Tied with Dembele on rating. But it's given it to us because we're the better team, obviously. Like, dude, not even a question. We are better. Everton beat Brighton. Crystal Palace lose to Liverpool. Fulham and Burnley draw. Manchester United and Arsenal draw. And West Ham beat Stoke.
Time for a quick question.
Yeah, quick question. Give me 7 questions, mate. I will answer them all. Congratulations, your winning streak is extended with today's match. How long do you hope to keep this on? I am focused on long-term success. Rather than put too much emphasis on our next match, I am focused on building long-term success at Bradford. You managed to win a close match with a decisive goal in the second half. What do you think made a difference in today's game? My players were sober. Nah, fuck it. I think we deserve to win based on how we played. It's a lie. We created enough chances. That's the truth. And the score could have been bigger. I mean, it could be like 5-2 or something. You think Bournemouth played well considering the scoreline was so tight? I'd say that I was drunk. Or tipsy at least. Yo, I'll give them credit. They surprised me, maybe all of us today. They had plenty of fight in them and made sure we earned it every step of the way. You know what? We'll give them credit. Like,
cheers. Thanks for the questions.
They did make it close. On a normal day, that isn't my birthday, that would have been an easy victory. But for some reason, they made us fight for it, which I guess is fair enough. Anyway, Haaland has got a message for us. It's the exact same message he sent us last time. Cheers for all the first team football I'm getting. I'll do my best, boss. We'll give him the same message as well. I'm proud to see you working hard and I look forward to seeing more from you on there, mate. But anyway, before we simulate to the next game, we'll go through the old training drills. I'll also talk to you guys about how either FCSB or Molder are going to qualify. We're already through. That's beyond a shadow of a doubt. There's no way that we're not going through. Martensen's tackling stats are irrational. Like, they're insane. Like, they shouldn't be that good. But they are that good. I'm going to use him to my advantage. Anyway, let's see how the results go. So that's got for Hill. Yartsev doing decent. Konstantinov getting close to 70. Martinsson working his way for 80 quite well. We will go to the Ajax game and I'll tell you guys what the... We're already through, as you can see by the standings. This is a final group stage game of the Europa League. And then we'll enter the round of 32, obviously. But I'll be playing this next time when I'm either sober / hungover. We'll see. I've been in pretty good form lately and I'm feeling good, so you're not going to bench me from the game against Ajax. I probably would have done, but because you've asked, I probably won't. I haven't figured out the squad yet, but I'll consider your request before announcing the team sheet. So we'll take a little look, gander at how things are going. We'll also take a look at the Premier League table as well, because I enjoy looking at the fact that I'm top. But anyway, this is how we're looking. That goal difference is unbelievable. The only reason it's that extortionate is because we beat Mulder 9-0 in the last game. You can see that on the right-hand side of the screen. But, we're already through and we're top. But Mulder and FCSB have a possibility of getting through. They're facing each other, though. So, the whole deal of it is, if FCSB win by 3 goals, they will go through. However, if FCSB win by only 2 goals, they will have the same goal difference, but I think based on how many they've scored... Wait, no. Maths, hold on. Give me a second, guys. Mulder are minus 11. FCSB are minus 9. So actually, FCSB could win by any score and they would go through on goal difference. Mulder, if they lose... Basically, if Mulder lose, they're out. If Mulder win, they're through. And if it's a draw, Mulder are through. Pretty much at the end of the day, we're already through. We don't give a fuck about Ajax, despite the fact that they won their last game against... FCSB, but like at the end of the day, we're already through, so we don't have anything to worry about. But it's about who goes through with us, because we may have to face them in a later round, and I don't want to risk that. But anyway, pretty much we are give me a second, guys, I'm trying to sort this, but yeah, no, anyway. Pretty much, at the end of the day, we're already through, so we don't have anything to worry about. I was going to check Premier League, guys. I'm sorry. I am an intoxicated human being. So I'm not really fully aware of my faculties. Premier League. Let's take a look at where we are. We're 7 points clear now with that win over Bournemouth, which is quite good. I think we can win this Premier League. We haven't dropped a point, or any points, since we faced Stoke. As for Bournemouth, they're in 16th. Stoke are in 17th, which is kind of concerning, the fact that we lost them and they've only won 2 out of 15. But the relegation zone is as follows. Burnley, Fulham and Crystal Palace occupy those spots, with Crystal Palace not even winning a single match. But that's going to be it for this episode of the Bradford City Career Mode. I hope you guys have enjoyed, and I'll see you next time. We take on Ajax and we travel to Holland for that match. But yeah, I'll see you then.